Alright, hello, good morning. My name is Cameron. Today I'm going to go briefly over collections in PLEX. PLEX is a home theater piece of software. It's got a server client setup, so its main benefit is you set up a PLEX server somewhere in your home. And then you can access it from many different clients, your phone, web browsers. It's built into TVs and Roku devices and all that, so it's widely available. So PLEX stands for Personal Libraries Entertainment Experience. And one of the things with PLEX is that it's not too customizable. They recently allowed for there to be color themes, so you can kind of change the appearance of it, but not the layout at all, just colors. Basically, it goes at the top, you've got your PLEX server. That's where you toss everything in there. And then there are libraries, which are individual folders on your server. And libraries are kind of sectioned off from each other. There's not many ways that libraries, that media within libraries, can interact with other library media. Movie libraries, TV libraries, pretty straightforward. They would be what you would expect. The movie libraries will have a folder for each movie, and within that folder you can have extras if you want, either in that same folder or in their own folder, either way. TV library has the folders at the show level, and then within that you've got every season, and then every episode, and then extras. Extras for TV shows aren't fully implemented yet. The extras for TV shows can actually be on any level. They can be at the show level, they can be at the season level, or the episode level. Trailers, interviews, deleted scenes, whatever. But that's new for TV, and the clients don't actually display that information yet. So currently, for TV extras, you've got a special season folder that they sit in, but they can't actually be tied directly into a specific season or tied to episodes. It's just another season that you manually navigate to. So we're going to be talking about these two today. And basically, one of the only ways you have to organize your media outside of this rigid folder structure. And that's with collections. So collections sit on the upper level. They virtually sit alongside your movie folders and alongside your show folders, is basically how to think of it. There's two types of collections, manual collections or smart collections. So manual collections are collections that have items that you specifically add to it. So on the page for a specific movie, you've got the little pencil. You click that, and then you get to the edit window for that. And you go down to tags, and then you can change any of this if you want to alter the genres. If a writer was omitted, or you want to add the producer or anything like that, you can just type it in. In general, it will start to autofill with, or give you a pre-populated list of stuff in your PLEX library that matches it. So if you start typing a producer, there was also, did work on a movie that's already in there, it'll pop up as you're typing. Same with collections. If you want to add something to a collection, if you just start typing and that collection already exists, it will pop up. If it doesn't, then you just, hit enter when you're done, and it creates that collection, basically. You go save changes. Then when you open up that collection, it'll tell you the range of dates of all the items within the collection, which can be interesting. There's some description text here that you can change. There's obviously, of course, nothing there by default, and you can just copy and paste something or type your own description or leave it blank. I like to have something there, even if it's just like a copy and paste, from Wiki or IMDb or something. It's not, you know, a little nice. So as you can see here, it's got all the movies from the franchise listed here. You can, you know, scroll through them, click through them. Then it also has a related TV show. So this is one of the only ways to navigate between libraries within the context of your media, if that makes sense. So if you have a collection in movies, in a movie library, and a collection in a TV show library, for example, that are named identically, their media is going to be all within that collection page. It will pull it all together. It will reorder them. They are going to be different collections, though. So if you can give the movie collection its own poster artwork, and you can give the TV show collection its own poster artwork. They don't have to be the same. They can even have different description text and all of that. So if I were to access the identically named collection from the TV show library instead of from the movie library, it would look potentially different, but it would have all the media. All the same media would be there. The TV show items would be on the top and the movies would be on the bottom, but it would still give you that bigger view of the franchise. So I think that's important to understand. That's really the only way that you can mix media like that. So manual collections, you click the little edit pencil, type in the collection, boom, done. Smart collections contain items that are dynamically chosen based on criteria. So at the top of one of your library menus, there's a little filter with the arrows. You click all, and at the very bottom, it's gonna list all of the stuff that you can filter things by. And then at the bottom, advanced filters is going to give you this setup right here. And what this will let you do is construct rule sets that it will use to filter your media, and then you can save that as a smart collection. So for example, if you go in here, decade is 1970s, save as smart collection. Now you've got a collection that will have everything from the 1970s, and that will change. So if you add a movie to your library, you don't have to go, oh hey, that belongs in this collection. No, the smart playlist will see it, pull it in, and take care of that for you. So if you are someone that has used PLEX and you've just dumped your stuff into your server without really much preparation or doing much beyond just setting it up and that's it, this is some ways you can make it a little bit easier to find what you want to watch. What I like to do with the collections is, because in the library tab they sit just literally just right next to movies, you'll have, but for stuff like four movie collection right here, you can see. And so for the franchise collections, I like to just have them in line with all the other movies. But with the genre or decade-based collections, or like network collections and, you know, director collections, anything like that, I generally like to have them floating at the top of my library. So at the top, whenever I go to my library, it's always going to be these genres and then these time periods. And then I just go a little bit further and I've got the general stuff. So if I'm not sure what to watch, I've got some options right here that I can just sort of flip through. I don't even think really that having a collection for like documentaries sit in the same space as your movies that start with the letter D makes any sense. So this is where we go in and we can edit the collection a little bit. So they give us a way to determine exactly how our libraries are shown. And they give us a few options. The first one is going to be hiding items in the collection. So when you edit the collection, you go down to advanced, you get just a few options. Collection mode. Hide items in this collection, show this collection and its items, or hide collection. So these three options, you can pick a default for the library that all collections will just have initially once created unless you manually change it. And what they mean is hide items in this collection means that items that are within a collection with this option chosen do not show up in your library. So they won't show up alongside other movies. They will only show up when you click that collection. So I've got this collection right here, which is a bunch of stuff. Old VHS tapes, movies that were direct to VHS or ripped from VHS. Some of them are like actual movies. Most of them are straight to DVD type stuff. Amazing, by the way. So these don't show up next to the other movies, right? This isn't going to be, if I look in my M's, this isn't going to be there. It's only going to be there if I click through to this collection and figure something out. So that hides the items in the collection from your library. And then show this collection and items is the opposite. It makes sure that they're shown in the library. And hide collection hides just the collection icon from the library tab. So I could make it so that this collection does not show up in the library tab, only the collections tab, which has no individual movies, just collections. Now, how do I make them all stay at the top? Well, when you edit something, not just collections, but movies, TV shows, edit anything, there's title and there's sort title. And sort title basically lets you provide a different value to use for the sorting, the alphabetical sorting of your media. So the typical use would be to take the articles off of the beginning of a title, so that you don't have, 7,000 things under T for the. But what you can also do is add a symbol at the very beginning. So I use the pound sign, number sign, hashtag in front of my genres, like horror. And that means that it's not going to be sorted in, it's going to say horror, but it's not going to sort it with the movies that start with H. It's going to start with the movies that start with that number sign. And then by doing the same thing with the decades and studios and things like that, it lets me, organize them in whatever order I want. So I believe the decade ones, there's a plus. And you just figure out which symbols the system interprets in which order, so you know how to, whichever ones you want first, you know what symbol you can use. And you just do that for all of them once you create them, and they're right up there. So that's pretty much the only way you can customize your media beyond just the artwork for it. I think it's very useful, and I think that people can, I think that there's a lot of interesting things you can do with it, and I'm trying to explore that a little. One of the things that I'm working on is I've made these posters for collections, for genre-based collections, and I've got kind of specific in some cases, courtroom drama, medical drama, etc. Different sci-fi subgenres. So what you can do and what I'm thinking of doing is you can set it up so under library it's like these main genres, but when you click over to collections, next to, for example, sci-fi, in between sci-fi and the next one, you can put specific collections there with the sort title. So you can make it so that right next to sci-fi is UFOs, time travel, and you know, cyborgs or something, right? So you can make it, when you're in the library, these are the main, you know, overarching genres that people generally agree upon. And then you go to collections and you get granular subgenres right next to them. And just the ones that you're interested in. You know, you can also do a collection that's always at the very top, that's new releases, any movie, you know, released in the last, you know, X months or whatever. You can have a collection that is just unplayed movies, or movies not played within the last year, or, you know, all sorts of stuff. There's a few things you can't filter by. I don't think you can do a collection that automatically has any item that has, like, extras. Like, if you have the trailer or interviews for a movie, I don't think that is a feature that it is able to determine. So that's about it. In the description box, there will be a link to the to these collection icons that I've made. It's free to download. I've got 152 individual posters. I think it works out to 50 some individual distinct genres, each with two or three different artwork designs. So those are free. You can just go and download them. Next, at some point, we'll be thinking about playlists as channels, TV channels, TV stations, and eventually beyond that, we'll actually go through and make some actual TV channels with our local content, which is something that I have not set up. I have no experience with in PLEX. I used it in XBMC for many years, a plugin called Pseudo TV. And PLEX has its own sort of thing, and I'm going to try and set that up and see if I can get it just the way I like it, which I could in Pseudo TV. Alright. Bye-bye.